Morning, trusty Ron Ransom-Hake, Fabriolo 130 pounds paper, 15 inches by 11, wet in wet, palette, lemon yellow, raw sienna, alizarin crimson, light red, ultramarine, burnt umber, Payne's grey, burnt sienna. I won't use them all. A bit of cloth for wiping the brush, keeping the water level right in it. The difficult thing about the Hake is the amount of water it holds. And once you get used to that, you're on your way. Right, a nice clean Hake. Got some water that I haven't used since Wednesday, I think I did a painting. Not been up to the mark this week, I'm afraid. Right, so I'm going to do a sort of a mountainy, woodlandy, streamy, tumbling type of scene anyway. So I wet the paper. I've got it at about 25 degrees. This way the gravity won't have such a pull on the wet. So give it a good dampening. You don't want it running off the board, but just give it a bit of a clench. I'll put a few pencil marks on this, but I'll rub most of them out because I'd rather just make it up as I go along. Right, bit of sienna, burnt sienna, just to warm up. The background, and it unifies the picture as well. You bring the same in the foreground as you've got in the sky above. Right, now what sort of, well, let's put a bit of alizarin in there, I think. A bit of lemon yellow, why not? Lemon yellow, alizarin crimson. Nice little number. Sort of a sunset-y type of painting. Well, we'll put in a bit of a Payne's grey and alizarin cloud over that. Bit darker here and there. Okay, that's quite a reasonable sky. And we'll let that dry off. I'll give it a reclip. What happens, because the paper's not so steep, the pigments tend to granulate. And you, especially colours like ultramarine and light red, which I haven't used yet, and burnt umber and ultramarine, they sort of separate out, and it gives a very, very pleasing effect. I'm going to dry this, so mute your sound, go. That'll do. Don't want it too dry. Now I'm going to put in some background. Let's have a bit of, yeah, well, let's use that alizarin and Payne's grey again in the background there. There. And a bit of sienna. Right, that's quite a good start. The colours dry much lighter than you put them on, so you have to make allowances for that. Right, let's put a bit of foreground here. Nice warm colours. Because then you can lift out some rocks. This one in there. This one's quite a cool red. Right, now while that's wet, we can take our card and just scrape into it. Let's get our rocky shore. Okay, it's so easy to do. We can put a few twigs and grasses and general foreground clutter. Okay, right, another little reclip. Okay, let's put in some background now. Autumny, wintry sort of colours. Matching the sky, really. Nice rich colour. When you're going over damp paper with another colour, you need to make it much thicker. Alright, let's put some greens and darker greens, yellows. So sort of pine trees dotted along here. So I'm climbing up a bit higher. Now some good, rich colours in here. Some bank. Right, just a few little flicks up with the fingernail. Some more green, Payne's grey and lemon yellow. Just to give a bit of variety in that background. So you see the edge of the, or corner of the hake. And I can put in some bit of bank in here now. rocks. Just Payne's grey and a bit of burnt sienna. It's a lovely, lovely rich dark. And we can just scrape out some of this. So we're trying to make an attractive painting. By using colour, texture, put some rocks in over here. Okay. Right, let's do a bit on this bank here now. So, nice greeny dark in there. Payne's grey. And lemon yellow. Not that dark there, it's just counter change against the background. Let's put some watery colours on there. Now the paper's drying nicely, you can get your dry brush in over all this. Dark shadowy bits. Bit of alizarin. Payne's grey. Okay, a bit sticking out here. And we can just flick in some of that. When that's dry, I can put some trunks in, connect up the dots. Right, okay, that's a nice group of trees, or it will be. Right, how's that doing there? Maybe some rocks in the middle of that, the water. So, there we go. Dark enough, so when you scrape it, it will show. Okay, we can have some bits of greeny stuff sticking out of that. See what the bottom of the hake was doing there. So let's just go a bit of shadowy colour. Right, now we can have the bit of a river going around that when that's dry. Just dry this off. Headphones. Now I'm using the hake for the trunks, just Payne's grey and a bit of sienna. deeper in some of and I can go over the front of some of this and just cover some of that up. Bit of a rigger. Now some dark dry brush, autumn-y colour. It's a bit of shadow. That. Got a strong contrast in there now. Okay, go away. Put some heavy green here. Right, give that a dry, and then we'll sort the water out, and then you flick some flourishes we want to add. Right, headphones. I'm going to use the mop for that, my goat hair mop. High quality goat hair wash brush, Pro Art number 6. So we want some of this nice yellowy, alizarin-y, sienna-y. Just shadow in there, Payne's grey, alizarin, it's a little bit darker, catching the bit of shadow nearby. Okay, I'll go let that go. Technically, it's probably wrong, but aesthetically, it's quite pleasing, warm, wintry picture. Put some birds in. Big, aren't they? Right, that's they're okay. Signature. Right, let's put that in amounts and we'll see what it looks like. Bring the board up a little bit, and we'll have a camera round. Never know where to have this sort of level. Oh, well, there we are. That could be anywhere, couldn't it? It could be Canada. So I've been pretty bad. I'm a little bit carried away there. Anyway, thanks for watching. Give it a title yourselves. See you soon. Bye bye.